It was a very noisy morning at the Flumps. Father Flump was making new floorboards because some of the old ones were squeaking. Poodle was playing on the squeaky floorboards and hoping that Father wouldn't fix them too soon.
I like squeaks. I like squeaks. Do you like squeaks, Grandfather?
I like the flumpet better, said Grandfather.
Do you like squeaks, Posey and Perkin?
Yes, I like squeaks, said Perkin, but I like playing snap better.
Snap! I'm winning!
Snap! You're not!
Snap! I am!
It's a loud sort of morning, said Poodle to himself. There's sawing and squeaking and flumpet music and snapping.
Oh, stop, everyone. Stop.
What's up, Mother Flump?
Said Father.
All that noise. That's what's up. My head is aching fit to bust, and the noise you lot were making sounded much too loud.
The cure for that is a nice, quiet rest. Come and sit down.
Here, have my chair, Mother. Take the weight off your feet and rest for a while.
I'll go and make a nice cup of herb tea. That's good for headaches.
And we'll all be as quiet as feather dusters from now on, said Grandfather.
I'll be as quiet as a snowflake, said Posey.
I'll be as quiet as carrots growing, said Perkin. I'll be as quiet as the wind, said Poodle.
The wind, said Perkin. But the wind can be very noisy when it blows. Very noisy.
Oh, all right. I'll be as quiet as a not blowing wind then, said Poodle.
But, Poodle, if the wind's not blowing, there isn't any wind.
That would be very quiet. Quieter than anything.
Well, neither of you are being quiet now. Just shush. Mother's trying to rest.
Ah, said Mother.
That's just what I need to make this headache go. A bit of peace and quiet.
Mother Flump had just settled down for a nap when...
Oh, what's going on? Whatever is that noise?
It's only me filling the kettle for your tea, said Father.
Well, this headache made it sound as loud as a waterfall.
That's a good job it wasn't. A waterfall wouldn't fit in this kettle. Never mind, Mother. I won't make any more waterfall noises. I'll get your tea made very quietly.
Shh. Shh. Poodle. Shh, Poodle. Shh, Poodle. I am shushing. It's the floorboards that aren't. That's because you're treading on a squeaking one. Come onto this one, it doesn't squeak. Oh, what on earth is that squeaking, creaking noise?
Sorry, it's me on the squeaky floorboard, said Poodle. But don't worry, I'm on a quiet one now. Oh!
That squeaky board sounds just like a giant's knees that need oiling, said Mother. It's this headache. Every little noise sounds 10 times louder than it really is.
We'll go and practice being quiet somewhere else, said Perkin. Come on, you two.
It's very hard to keep quiet when the floorboards won't, said Poodle to himself.
Just like giant's knees that need oiling, said Mother.
Giant's knees? Said Father. Mother Flump must be dreaming and talking in her sleep. I'll leave her tea here and go and tell the others to keep extra quiet.
You know, Father, said Poodle, Mother Flump's headache makes the tap running sound like a waterfall and the squeaky floorboards sound like giant's knees knocking.
Oh, Poodle, not knocking knees, creaky knees.
There mustn't be any creaking or knocking because Mother Flump is asleep.
We aren't creaking and knocking. The knees were.
Knees? Said Father. I think you must be getting mixed up again, Poodle. Never mind about knees. We must shush.
I know you're all trying to be quiet, but every time you shush, it sounds like and I just can't stay asleep.
I think we'd better go outside so Mother Flump can have some peace and quiet, said Father. Here you are. You three can look at the book and keep yourselves quiet while Grandfather and I find a quiet job to do.
Are there pictures of noises in the book, Posy?
Oh, Poodle, you don't see noises, you hear them. You can't have a picture of a noise.
Well, there are pictures of animals in here. Animals make noises. What noise does that animal make? Said Poodle. Does it go squeak, squeak?
Oh, Poodle, said Perkin. It's a cat. It goes meow. Meow.
Well, does that animal go meow?
Oh, Poodle, said Posy, it's a duck. It goes quack, quack.
That animal is too big to squeak. What is it?
That's a cow, said Posy. It goes moo, moo.
Isn't there any animal that squeaks? Said Poodle. I like squeaks best.
There you are, Poodle, said Perkin. That's a mouse. That squeaks.
It's very small, said Poodle.
It only makes small squeaks, said Perkin.
That's better than no squeaks at all, said Poodle. What noise does that make?
I don't think fish make any noise at all, said Posy.
They might, said Poodle. They might go gobble, 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 bloop.
But they don't, said Perkin. I like the noise ducks make.
Quack, 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 quack.
I like cows, said Posy. Moo!
I like the mouse going squeak. Oh, sorry, Mother Flump. Did that sound like the giant sneeze again?
Oh, dear. Did we wake you up?
We forgot the book was supposed to keep us quiet, said Perkin. It made us noisy instead.
It doesn't matter, said Mother. I've had a good rest and my headache is gone. Headache gone? That's good news, Mother. I'm glad you're feeling better. And now Grandfather and I can fix the floorboard.
Oh, no. No more squeaky floorboards. What am I going to do for Squeaks now?
I like that noise, don't you, Posy? Said Perkin.
Sounds a bit like music, doesn't it? Said Posy.
Listen, everyone. Can you hear that noise?
I found a squeaky by toy, said Poodle. It's a better squeak than the floorboards, and I don't want it fixed. I like it, just the way it is. ¶¶